The check, the certificates, the two silver medals will be presented to Fletch Wheeler.
Первое, что поразило меня, это то, что Ронни Кольман приехал в зал на тренировку на инвалидном кресле. И когда он прилетел в Россию, его тоже выкатили на инвалидном кресле. К сожалению, здоровье сейчас у короля не самые лучшие времена. Но знаете, что поражает? Вот до этого мы снимали Флекса, Кевина. И если бы я им не предложил тренировку, вряд ли бы у них была тренировка в этот день. А Ронни Кольман, он находится уже четвертый день в Москве, и он каждый день делает тренировку в конце дня. И это и поражает. С ним приехали менеджеры и так далее, которые его пытаются отговорить, каждый день отговаривают от тренировки. Дескать, ты устал, погоди, не порть здоровье. А Ронни сказал, где мой претреник, где мой претренировочный комплекс, выпил его и, ковыляя, дошел до этого тренажера. Нормально? Нормально. Сегодня, как вы понимаете, тренировка фоновая. За тренировку мы особо не будем разговаривать, потому что Ронни делает все то, что сидя, либо лежа, да, в силу своего состояния здоровья. Но у меня есть что у него спросить и есть что обсудить. Я думаю, будет интересно.
Yeah, buddy. Lightweight, good. Baby. Lightweight for real. Wow.
Great. Первый вопрос, Ронни, к тебе по состоянию, конечно, твоего здоровья. Все мы хотим, чтобы ты жил долго и счастливо.
I just had surgery about 4 or 5 months ago. I had the fusion. Lower back fusion, levels L3, L4, I got four screws about this long in my back, and they fused them together. It's one of the most difficult surgeries out there, one that takes about almost a year and a half to 2 years to heal. So I haven't had a chance to go to the doctor yet because I've been so busy. So periodical checkups. I go to the doctor probably about every other month. It's about time for me to go see him and see what's going on. So I'll go to the doctor when I get back home, and we'll find out what the problem is. And normally we fix it, you know. So it just takes time for me to just go to the doctor and see what the problem is and fixing it, you know. Something that I've had before, so it's nothing new.
Ронни, твои видео были самые мотивирующие. Я до сих пор, когда у меня нет аппетита, пересматриваю их, и сразу появляется аппетит, и хочется идти на тренировку. Но в твоих видео, когда еще в самом начале моих занятий, когда я смотрел, меня поразило, что ты довольно мало для своего веса ешь. У тебя было там 4-5 приемов пищи, не очень больших, но ты показал такое физическое развитие, которое до тебя и после тебя никто не показывал. Тогда в чем же твой секрет?
Genetics. Got the best genetics in the whole wide world. Best genetics on the planet. I think God gave me part of his genetics, pretty much. I always tell people that I have God-given genetics. When I say God-given genetics, it's like I got a part of God in me. With me at all times.
Да, но учитывая тот факт, что ты в начале своей карьеры был далеко не самая лучшая генетика, казалось бы, у тебя, да? Ты начал побеждать не сразу, как это был Флекс или тот же Кевин, да? Ты плелся в последних местах всегда, и потом произошел некий качественный скачок, и ты начал побеждать. Вот с чем это связано?
I think I'm gonna have to jump on me because when I got into the sport of bodybuilding, I just got introduced into it. I'd never done it before in my whole entire life. So they had already been there for about 4 or 5, maybe 6 years. And, you know, I was just like 1 year into the game. So they had more experience than me. They had been around and they were more well known than I was. I was just like the new kid on the block. So once I, you know, got more experience, paid my dues, worked my way into the lineup, I was a little bit more competitive with those guys then.
Что касается твоих тренировок, мы знаем все, что они были самые тяжелые, и они действительно давали результат. Все видели твою форму. Но многие атлеты твоего возраста, у них сейчас состояние здоровья, ну, лучше, да, и колени там, и, допустим, Кевин вообще сказал, что у него никогда вообще ничего не болело. Ты как считаешь, можно ли было в то время тебе заниматься чуть легче, чтобы сохранить свое здоровье? Либо ты считаешь, что ты все правильно сделал?
When you have like natural strength, you know, it had anything to do with nothing but just having natural strength. There were a couple times that, you know, when I had like 800 pounds on the bar, you know, especially when I did the squat, you know, I feel, well, I know in my heart I could have did maybe 5-6 reps when I only did like 2 or 3, because I was trying to get ready for the Mr. Olympia and I didn't want to you know, take the chance on injuring myself. You know, I always tell people, you know, when you got natural strength, you're just naturally strong. I started powerlifting when I was in high school, so I just carried that, you know, that powerlifting background. And I put it in the bodybuilding, and you know, it just allowed me to train that much heavier than the guy. So the injuries today, I don't really think has a whole lot to do with you know, me training heavy and stuff. There were a couple times where I made some mistakes and got injured, you know, but it is what it is. When I was talking to the doctor, he said that no matter what, you know, my hip was gonna give out because genetics in my family. Everybody, all the men in my family had their hips replaced because we just got a history of bad hips. Like some people have history of heart problems or kidney problems or whatever. Well, in my family, we had a history of bad hips. My brother has had his place, my uncle, I mean, all of us. So nothing you can do about that.
Хорошо, но как ты относишься к такому подходу, к примеру, как у Фила Хита, да, который не стремится больше набирать мясо, который работает, грубо говоря, с той формой, что у него сейчас есть, постепенно, постепенно, по чуть-чуть улучшая ее, возможно, детализация, да, где-то, возможно, форма мышц. И это действительно в его случае работает.
Yeah, yeah, but you gotta look at the level of his competition. His competition is not that much higher than it was when I was competing. My competition was a little bit more threatening than his was. I mean, he really don't have to train that heavy. I mean, for what? I mean, what he's doing is working. So you got to do what works for you, and what he's doing is working for him. So why, you know, risk training heavy if you don't have to? I mean, but it all shows with the body. I always have a saying, everybody want to be a bodybuilder, but don't nobody want to lift no heavy-ass weight. You know, my body projected me lifting the heavy weight. I had that certain look. I had that certain thickness to my body. So Phil don't really need all of that because the level of competition that he's up against don't have that. See, when I was coming up, those guys were killing me. You know, I was getting beat, you know, in every show. And it took a long time for me to overcome them. And, you know, and it took a long time for me to come around to beating those guys because they were way up here and I was way down there. And so I had to slowly work myself up, 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 and then jump over them. So, you know, and to get there, I had to lift heavy. You know, ain't no other way I would have got there.
Ты достиг такого уровня, да, то есть бодибилдинг развивался, развитие бодибилдинга, грубо говоря, закончилось на тебе. То есть был Ли Хейни, потом стал еще лучше Дориан Йейтс, потом стал ты еще лучше. Теперь бодибилдинг работает не над прогрессом, а, грубо говоря, над той формой, которая есть. И, в принципе, это обосновано с точки зрения того же здоровья и так далее. Но ты как считаешь? Ты, наверное, ты отдаешь себе отчет в том, что на тебе остановилось развитие бодибилдинга, и как ты сейчас относишься к положению дел в бодибилдинге?
Yeah, yeah, you know, I never consider myself the greatest, but people have labeled me that, and so why not take a good compliment? You know, I'm not gonna turn down a bad compliment. If they think it, then I'm all for it. But I'm not gonna go out and say, you know, I'm this and I'm that. I've always been a humble person, you know. That's the way I was brought up, you know. So I'm never gonna be an arrogant person and say I'm greater than this guy, I'm greater than that guy, I'm better than this guy, I'm better than that guy. I'm just gonna take the compliments as they come, and I'm gonna be real happy with them because I did work real hard to get to where I am, and I'm real happy with the way bodybuilding has progressed. When I was winning the Olympia, I was only getting $110,000. Phil Heath got $400,000. So that's three times what I was making. So I'm real happy with the way the bodybuilding has progressed and the popularity of the sport. I mean, I remember the last time I was in Russia, you know, they didn't have hardly any shows. Now they got the Olympia here in Russia, even though it's the amateur Olympia, but it's got the title of Olympia in it. So I'm real happy with the way bodybuilding has progressed, especially in Russia, because like I said, Russia has some of the best bodybuilding fans in the whole wide world.
Ронни, меня интересует один вопрос. Когда ты достигаешь какого-то уровня, тебя кто-то постоянно мотивирует. Что мотивировало тебя, когда ты был столько лет лучшим и в отрыве от всех? Где ты черпал тогда мотивацию?
For me, since I was kind of like new to the sport, I didn't really know anything about the sport because I came from actually from a powerlifting background. So I didn't know anything about bodybuilding. I didn't know really what bodybuilding was. I was introduced to bodybuilding from the guy at my gym. His name is Brian Dobson. And Brian had competed, you know, for about 15 years. So when Brian saw me come into the gym, he's like, man.
I know, bro.
You should be bodybuilding. I'm like, what is that? Wow. I'm like, I'm from, we just did powerlifting. Now, nobody did bodybuilding. Like, man, you should do bodybuilding because you could probably be like world champion or something one day. You could probably be Miss Olympia. I'm like, I don't think I can do none of that stuff, dude, because I've never bodybuilded before. I've always been into powerlifting. You know, powerlifting is my thing, and I don't like the diet. And I just got hired by the police department, so I just want to stick to powerlifting. Well, Brian kind of convinced me to go into bodybuilding by saying, I give you a free membership to the gym if you compete in this show that's coming up in like about 3 or 4 months. He's like, I teach you how to train as a bodybuilder. I teach you how to diet as a bodybuilder. He said, I even teach you how to pose and everything. And once he said free, he had me hooked. I'm like, let's do it. I'm always down for something free, especially when I'm struggling. And at the time, I was real struggling. I had a lot of financial problems. So that's how I got into the sport of bodybuilding, you know, because I didn't know anything about it before then.
Так как у нас передача такая более для людей, кто в теме непосредственно, хочется позадавать тебе конкретные вопросы про питание. Когда ты набирал массу, да, какого количества углеводов ты придерживался? И самый минимум на углеводный твой, когда ты готовился к соревнованиям?
It's like when I first started bodybuilding, I didn't know anything about diet. You know, that was one of the reasons why I didn't want to bodybuild, because I used to eat pizza all the time. I actually just worked for Domino's Pizza, where I eat pizza every single
Flex
day.
Flex like pizza.
It was my favorite food, though. I eat it every day because I work there. So it's a little bit different. But then I got tired of eating pizza, and I started trading pizza for hamburgers. Then I got tired of eating hamburgers, and I started trading pizza for fried chicken. So those are the kind of foods that I like. I didn't want anything else. So Brian convinced me basically by saying he'd give me a free membership to the gym if I competed. And I wasn't about to turn that free membership down, you know. So he had me eating like, I like chicken. He just had me eating the food that I like, basically. So I like chicken, so I just grilled it, you know. He let me, steaks. I like steaks. And see, at the time, I like turkey, so he let me eat turkey. So only difference was, you know, I grilled everything. So I just bought a gas grill and cooked everything at home. My favorite carbs were like baked potatoes and rice. And every now and then I would eat some yams or something like that. But for the most part, it was just, you know, baked potatoes and rice. But for the breakfast, I ate mostly oatmeal, grits. My carb intake back when I first started, you know, I didn't really know too much about it. So I was doing probably about 300 to 400 grams of carbs a day, you know, but I was doing it all wrong, which I found out, you know, later on. My protein intake, I wasn't eating a whole lot of protein either. I was probably doing about maybe 400 grams of protein per day. So I had my protein and carbs were pretty much the same. As far as fat, you know, I really didn't do a lot of fat. I got fat mostly from the chicken, from the steak, or whatever was in the turkey or whatever. So my fat content was real low back in those days. So I just had a basic diet. And a lot of people don't know this. Well, they may know it because they see me in the videos and stuff, but I never, ever liked vegetables. And I don't know how I pulled it off, but I was able to pull that off. I guess good genetics helps out in all kind of ways. So I had a basic diet, you know, it's just chicken, turkey, steak, baked potatoes, rice, yams, whatever. That was it, you know. I didn't do fish, I didn't like fish.
Хорошо, но на некоторых видео, я помню, что по воскресеньям вы собирались с полной семьей, и ты ел там какие-то тортики и так далее, то есть устраивал cheat day. До какого, ты постоянно его делал, каждую неделю, и за сколько до соревнований ты его убирал? Либо при подготовке к соревнованиям у тебя уже не было таких cheat дней?
I never ever had a cheat day when I was getting ready for a contest. So if you saw me eating the cakes on the Sunday with the family, it was always in the off season. Because once I started my diet, there were no cheat days. Never, ever. I always just ate, you know, diet food the whole time. Never a cheat day. So I had all my cheat days in the off season. Okay. And once I started the contest, all the cheat days was over with.
Ryan, this set for you.
Lightweight.
Thank you.
Nothing but a peanut. Yeah, buddy. You got it. Ain't nothing to that. Like you can do those all day long. Come on. Come on. Get that chest bigger. Get that chest bigger.
Ребят,
there you go. Good set.
Да, это было не в наушниках. Это был настоящий Ронни Коллиман. Когда я делал подход, он говорил lightweight. Это фантастика.
Lightweight, baby. Okay. Lightweight, baby. Okay. Yeah, buddy. Come on. Lightweight. You got it, baby. Come on. Come on. 14. Yep. 15. Easy one.
Лучший предтреник Ронни Коллиман. Сейчас стало модно говорить о животах, о больших животах. Все об этом говорят, что это некрасиво и так далее. Лично мое мнение, что нельзя развить огромную мускулатуру, физику, как у тебя, не прогрессируя в животе. Ты сам как считаешь, это действительно была твоя проблема, и можно было минимизировать развитие, да, среднего сектора? Либо ты считаешь, что все было норм?
I never had a problem with my stomach. Maybe a couple of times that, you know, when I relaxed on stage or something, but you look at me when I hit my abs, my stomach was just as flat as the next guy. So, of course, when you are big, they're going to try to look to find something that's weak on you, no matter what. Whether it's weak or not, they're going to try to find something that's weak on you. Especially when you at the top and you're number one. And you're number one year after year after year after year. So they're looking for something to bring you down. So anybody and everybody pretty much has a big stomach if you are a bodybuilder, because you gotta fill your stomach up. You gotta expand your stomach to eat the food that it takes to put size on you. Well, the problem is that wearing that falters you. It makes you look bad is when you relax and you let your stomach kind of like stick out a little bit. But if you're just up there and you're focused on it and you're not relaxed and you're holding it in, and then it's okay. But once you just relax and just let it hang, somebody gonna, you know, do everything in their power to bring you down. But if you look at me, even when I'm hitting my transition, my stomach is just as flat as the next guy's. They're just a couple times, you know, that it relaxed. So I wouldn't say I had no weakness. If I had a weakness, then they would have marked me down. I wouldn't have won 8 Mr. Olympias. You know, they had each and every opportunity to take Olympia from me, and they didn't. So I still won 8 in a row. So I had no weak points if I was winning 8 Mr. Olympias in a row.
Существует два мнения по поводу соревнований, прогресса и так далее. Это то, что одно мнение: нужно всегда держать себя в форме, и только тогда при круглогодичной работе над собой, только тогда возможен постоянный прогресс. Другие же утверждают, что наоборот, нужно полностью отдыхать. Ну, пример тому Кевин Леврон, да? Легкий тренинг в межсезонье, и только тогда ты можешь добавлять к соревнованиям. Как ты считаешь, что вернее?
Yeah, I believe that you should be in shape pretty much year round, because once you allow yourself to get out of shape and get fat and all that kind of stuff, it's so much harder. You got to work so much harder to get rid of all that fat and stuff. And it's kind of hard to get rid of a lot of fat and not lose a lot of muscle at the same time. So the best thing to do is just stay like even. You know, you don't have to be in tip-top shape. You can relax and have a few bad meals here and there. But I found out that when I stayed in shape, the less time I had to die. There were a few times where I let myself go and got way out of shape, and I had to die for about 12 weeks. But when I didn't, and I stayed in shape, you know, I was able to die for only like 9 weeks. Also, when I had to diet, the longer you diet, the more muscle and more fat you're gonna lose. So you don't wanna have to diet for too long. So the best thing to do is stay in shape pretty much, so you don't have to diet that long and lose that much muscle.
Ронни, совсем недавно у меня в передаче был Флекс Уиллер, с которым я обсудил тему той первой Олимпии, когда ты стал чемпионом, он стал вторым, хотя все думали, что станет он чемпионом. Он разоткровенничался и сказал, что после первого дня он лидировал, что ты подходил к нему и говорил, что, возможно, он мистер Олимпия, да, и так далее. Вот. Ты сам как ту ситуацию видишь? Мне кажется, ты из-за уважения к нему так сказал. Но твои мысли на этот счет?
Well, that was a long time ago. Yeah. And a lot that happened since then. And that's one of the things I don't even remember. I don't even remember how I got back to my room. Only thing I remember the prejudging is Joe Weider coming up to me after the show was, the prejudging was always like, man, you're gonna win this thing. I'm like, what? I'm like, what are you talking about? I'm like, we watching the same show? I'm like, I'm not gonna win this thing. He's like, yeah, you're gonna win it. I'm like, no, Joe, I'm not gonna win. I'm just trying to make the top five. And that's really all I remember. I remember talking to Joe and taking pictures, and that's it. I don't know how I got back to the room or nothing. So if that happened, I don't recall.
В любом случае, как бы там ни было, мне кажется, что последующие 10 лет Ронни все показал, и диалоги на этот счет, они неуместны.
One more? In the row, yeah. I think, yeah, it's kind of proves a little bit of something. Oh, yeah, baby.
Two, three. Let's go. Okay.
Lightweight.
Yes, sir.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, buddy.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Easy.
Yeah, I know. That was real easy.
Maybe Mr. Olympia 16.
In my dreams.
Ah, true.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Ooh. Yeah, buddy. Ooh. Come on. Ooh. You got this. Like,
oh,
wait,
oh,
baby,
oh,
nothing but peanut.
Who?
Hello, everybody. For anybody that got any questions out there, go ahead and ask them right now. Yeah, buddy.
Колоссальное количество вопросов пришло на Instagram. В основном все, конечно, восхищаются тобой и выражают респект. Очень много вопросов о том, как накачать бицепс, как накачать ноги и так далее. Ребят, по этим всем вопросам есть много фильмов с Ронни, где видно, как он тренируется. Поэтому я не буду эти вопросы задавать. Я выберу интересные какие-то вопросы, которые, возможно, никто не задавал. Вот мне понравился вопрос по поводу твоей работы в полиции. Были ли какие-то забавные случаи? Расскажи про это.
Well, for the most part, you know, working full-time for the police department and doing bodybuilding was fairly easy for me because I was doing something that I truly loved. I loved working for the police department. I loved bodybuilding. I look forward to doing each one of them both days. There was never a day where, you know, I was regretting going to work. There was never a day I was kind of like regretting going to the gym or working out. There was always days where I always looked forward to going to the gym. Always days I looked forward to going to work for the police department. I can still remember it like it was yesterday. When I found out that I had to retire from the police department, it was like more like a forced retirement. It's like, oh, well, we see that you're not here that much because you always gone, you always on the road, you always traveling. So probably be better you just go on, just do that, you know, because you really don't have a lot of time. I mean, of course, they were right, but I kind of like cried like I was a little bit of baby. I was depressed and I probably cried for about a couple hours, you know, just thinking about not being able to go to work and do something that I truly enjoyed. So to me, working full-time in the police department and being a full-time bodybuilder was the highlight of my day, each and every single day.
Многие спрашивают про твой распорядок дня. Я помню, что были много комментариев по поводу того, что на видео ты вставал рано, но всем ты говорил, что ты встаешь после обеда. Твой начинается график после обеда и заканчивается после полуночи. Расскажи свое расписание дня примерно.
Well, off-season, for the most part, I still had to work full time for the police department, so I had to get up by a certain time. That certain time was normally about 10 o'clock, 10:30, somewhere in there. Because I had to go to the gym, get my workout on. I had to come home and eat, then go to work, you know, after I shower and everything. But during the pre-contest, I got up every single morning at the same time, at the same meal, same time of day. And that time was like 7 a.m. Same time every single day, whether it was I had to work, I didn't have to work, but when I had to work, I still had to get up at that same time. I got up at 7 a.m. every single morning. But the only thing about it is I went back to bed at 8 and got up about, you know, 11 somewhere in there so I could get my second meal of the day, do my cardio and shower and everything after I hit my workout before I went to work. So I get up at 7 a.m., have my first meal of the day, and normally that took me about a good hour or so. So I went back to bed about 8 a.m., slept for about another 3 hours, got up at 11, got immediately on the treadmill because it was right beside my bed, and did my hour cardio. And when I got through my cardio, ran downstairs and got my second meal of the day in. When I finished my second meal of the day, I ran to the gym, did my workout, ran back home, had another meal, and went to work. Like clockwork, every single day.
Не так давно Фил Хит сказал, что он рассчитывает на абсолютный рекорд, на 10 титулов Мистер Олимпия. И мне кажется, это реально, потому что бодибилдинг сейчас переживает, как мы с тобой уже общались, да, такой период, что атлеты работают прежде всего не над прогрессом, а над формой, над формой мышц, над глубиной и так далее. Как ты думаешь, получится ли у него это? И в целом, в ближайшие 10 лет, как ты видишь развитие бодибилдинга?
Well, I always say only God knows that kind of stuff, because anything can happen when you get ready for Mr. Olympia. I mean, there are so many variables. I mean, somebody could come from ninth place to first place and beat him. somebody can come from second place to first place and beat him, or third place. He can get injured. There's just so many things that can happen. So I always say just about anything is possible. And when I say anything is possible, anything is possibly can happen also. So he can win his 10 Miss Olympias. He can not win them by, you know, getting injured, just getting beat by somebody, you know, just fairly close to him. Somebody not fairly close to him like it was when I won it. I went from ninth place all the way to first place. You know, you always got that second place guy that's right there on your heels. You know, never know when he can overtake you like Jay did me. So anything is possible to happen in this Mr. Olympia game. So I ain't going to say he ain't going to do it, and I ain't going to say he's going to do it. I'm going to say only God knows.
Что ж, друзья, вы знаете, больше всего меня сегодня поразило то, что, когда я задал вопрос, мог бы ты тренироваться легче, и тогда бы ты сохранил здоровье, но все равно бы оставался мистер Олимпия, на что он ответил, если бы я мог тренироваться тяжелее, я бы еще тяжелее тренировался. И в этом весь Рон. Он приехал сюда на коляске, он еле ходил от тренажера к тренажеру, но когда он делал упражнения, его глаза светились, он жил. И он живет только этим по сей день. Спасибо тебе, Рон. Thank you, Ronnie. Thank you.
My pleasure. Enjoyed it. Had some fun.
И спасибо вам, что были с нами. До новых встреч.
Well, goodbye, everybody. I had fun, I enjoyed it, I always look forward to coming back, so see y'all real soon. Yeah, buddy, lightweight baby, still ain't nothing but a peanut.